Hello, welcome all. Today again I have come with a new project which is RFSoC. So first of all we'll see what is ZYNQ-RFSOC+TM RFSoC, and we'll start this RFSoC development kit application using the Avnet RFSoC Explorer and graphical user interface in MATLAB. So we'll need that's RFSoC development kit manufactured by Avnet and the MATLAB for user interface. Let's start it. So let's start with RFSoC development kit overview. The Avnet ZYNQ-RFSOC development kit with Qorvo RF Front End enables system architect to explore the entire signal chain from antenna to digital using tools from MathWorks and industry-leading RF components from Qorvo. We extend the functionality of the Xilinx ZYNQ-RFSOC ZCU111 evaluation kit by adding the Qorvo 2x2 small cell RF front end card plus native connection to MATLAB and Simulink with Avnet's RFSoC Explorer application, which you will get in the MATLAB application. So this is the board. This is a ZYNQ-RFSOC RFSoC board. This is the Qorvo RF front end card, and this is the RFSoC Explorer by Avnet in MathWorks. So let's see what are the objectives. This tutorial is intended to help you gain familiarity with the Avnet RFSoC development kit with Qorvo RF front end. Use the Avnet RFSoC Explorer GUI to control the hardware, generate and acquire signals in MATLAB through the RF signal chain of the Qorvo card. Explore the Avnet RFSoC Explorer user API for automated scripting and interface to MATLAB. Now we'll see what are the requirements for this project. Laptop or PC with the following software installed: MATLAB 2019B, free MATLAB trial package for wireless communications available, TSP system toolbox. MathWorks support package for Xilinx RFSoC based radio, Avnet ZYNQ, UltraScale+ RFSoC development kit with Qorvo RF front end, USB cable, and CAT 5 Ethernet cable. Xilinx Vivado is not required. Tool setup. So how to set up the tool? Create a folder where RFSoC Explorer will reside. That's all. So to this block diagram overall, this is our ZCU111 board. This is the Qorvo card, and this is the PC where this RFSoC Explorer software is installed. To enable your PC to make serial connection to the ZCU111 USB UART, you must install the Silicon Labs CP210 USB 2 UART PCB drivers. For step-by-step, see Appendix 1 installation. Connect the Qorvo RF card to ZCU antenna and cables as shown in Figure 4. Although no what the ARA transmission reception is involved in this tutorial, the antenna provide convenient waveform termination to the power amplifier. Plug Ethernet and USB cables into your PC, your host PC. Now how to boot your ZCU111 board. Turn on ZCU111 power switch on near 12 volt connection. Now this is the serial connection settings, whatever we have done. 115200 baud rate. From your PC, launch a terminal program with 115200 baud rate setting. For example, output shown here, teratram was used. For information, setting teratram you will see in USB UART port. Next page. You should disable terminal, observe terminal output from UART and then Linux output appear in the teratram window. After the final boot message server init done, press enter to generate a carriage return at command line prompt on ZCU111. Next. Now Ethernet TCP connection. Upon booting to Linux, the ZYNQ-RFSOC Ethernet port should have an IP address. Discovered it by running the ipconfig command. This is the thing which we have generated. So ZYNQ-RFSOC Ethernet IP in this example is 192.168.0.105. Now, so we'll generate a CW tone through the TX path from this UltraScale board. The power amplifier output each in each channel of Qorvo RF card is routed back to RF ADC through the directional coupler, this one, providing an observation path. Typically, this observation path used for digital pre-distortion of the power amplifier. In this experiment, we shall generate a CW tone in the digital domain from the RFSoC Explorer graphical user interface GUI running on the MATLAB on the host PC. The digital signal data will be downloaded to the board over TCP and stored in the DDR4 memory dedicated to RFTAC. Once download is complete, the signal data will be read out of the memory buffered to the DMA and routed to the digital up converter. This is the digital up converter. Within the RFTAC dial, interpolated. Within the RFTAC dial, interpolated to higher sampling rate, frequency shifted to 1842 MHz through the complex mixer and converted to analog domain by RFTAC. This process repeats indefinitely and constantly looping back to the start of the data in the memory buffer after reaching the end to generate a CW tone at the output of the DAC. To avoid discontinuity between the start and the end loops points of the CW tone, RFSoC Explorer automatically adjusts the signal length to an integer number of cycles, thereby ensuring a smooth zero crossing upon looping back to the start of the data. The directional coupler at the output of the PA routes to the RF signal back towards the RF DAC ADC on the ZYNQ-11 card with 20 dB of attenuation, normally intended as an observation path for digital PA distortion and PA linearization. This provides a convenient means of recording a PA output signal into the digital domain without any external connection. Our objective here is simply to demonstrate usage of RFSoC Explorer to generate and acquire signal and control the RF signal chain. We shall leave PA linearization for next tutorial. So first of all, we'll start MATLAB 2019. In MATLAB, change directories to the folder where RFSoC Explorer was installed. For this tutorial, we shall use the following direction. So C, Avnet RF socket. At the MATLAB command line, launch RFSoC Explorer using the following syntax. This RFSoC equals to Avnet RFSoC Explorer. So here is the thing. So the mapping RFSoC data on the Z211 board that connects signal paths of the Qorvo RF card, dial-in block integrates are zero based for ADC blocks. Now we shall see how to do the frequency planning. The frequency planning involves selecting appropriate sampling rates, accurate zone of operation, and digital signal processing according to signal bandwidth, IF frequency, and board level filtering. In this case, the bandwidth of LTE band 3 is 75 MHz centered at 184.2 MHz in the downlink. While the bandwidth of the RFATC could easily support direct RF conversion of the 1842 MHz IF in the first Nyquist zone, the relatively small instantaneous signal bandwidth of 75 MHz would make such an approach wasteful of resources and power. We shall instead aim to match the response of the digital half-band filters in the decimation stage of the digital down conversion to the bandwidth of LTE band 3 signal. The decimation filters are flat out of to 80% Nyquist passband or 0.4f into fs. Based on 75 MHz bandwidth of the LTE band 3 signal, we derive a suitable sampling rate at RFATC shown below. So this is the band of 75 MHz. And 0.4 into FADC divided by D is greater than of 75 MHz by 2, solving for FADC. So it is the FADC and this in fact in D yields a suitable sampling rate for the RFADC. So D should be 8 and so F should be greater than of 75 MHz. Now if this is the 1 MHz CW tone is generated in the digital domain. So we can see, so that is C. 1 MHz signal generated in digital by RFSoC Explorer is sent through the interpolation filter and shifted in frequency by complex mixer in the digital up converter to form an analytic signal tone at 184.3 MHz. Once converted to the analog domain, to the signal connects to the transmit path of the Qorvo car to reach the power amplifier, where it is routed back through the directional coupler. This is the route, directional coupler to the RFADC. This is the RFADC within the observation path normally used for PA linearization. At the RFADC, the sampling process produces vertical virtual copies in the digital domain of the baseband signal centered at multiple of sampling frequencies. Careful frequency planning can exploit this phenomenon to retrieve the signal of interest without need of high sampling rate that is greater than the highest frequency component of the analog signal, which in this case is 1,843 MHz. By purposely sampling at the lower rate to create aliasing, copies of signal can be made to appear at convenient frequency locations outside of first Nyquist zone. This is known as undersampling. So, configuring the RFIDC in the DPT observation path. We start by enabling the ADC block for the DPT observation path in channel 1 of the Qorvo RF card, which connects to ADC 07 tile 3 block 1 of the RFIOC device on ZCU111. Enable ADC tile 3 in RFIOC Explorer and click to enter the tile. So let's enable the ADC 2230. This is the ADC block that connects to the channel 1 observation path of the Qorvo RF card. Click OK. This is the warning box. You will perform ADC calibration in the later step. Now adjust the ADC tile to the clock 1081.344 MHz. That controls the sampling rate of both the RF ADCs in the tile. The configuration process communicates with the Xilinx RFDC Linux driver API running on the processing system API of the RFSoC, providing runtime interaction and monitoring of the data converters. RFSoC responds with the actual ADC tile sampling frequency that was programmed in the internal PLL. Click OK to dismiss the dialog box. The RFIDC block for the DPD observation path of the Qorvo RF card has been activated. We can now re-enable the TX driver and power amplifier of the Qorvo card. So in the TCL script, type T at the terminal command in line by follower carriage return, then type 1 to enable the power amplifier in channel 1 of the Qorvo card. Type P at the terminal command followed by carriage return, then type 0 to enable the TQL9092 driver amplifier in channel 1. Channel 1 TX single jail of the Qorvo card has been enabled, while the digital attenuator rates remain at the maximum attenuation. We now proceed to configuration the RFDAC to generate a CW tone of the Qorvo card. So, configuring the RFDAC in the transmit path, enable DAC type 1 in RFSoC Explorer and click to enter the dial. So enable RFDAC block 2 connecting to channel 1 in 1 transmit path of the Qorvo card. So here 1 MHz signal has been generated. So now adjust the DAC tile to clock to 6389.76 MHz. This sets the sampling rate for all 4 DAC in the tile. Leave signal source parameters to default values. CW tone, complex, ZD bass, and 1 MHz. Set the complex mixer within the RFTSC tile to center frequency of LT band 3, 1842 MHz. The resulting CW tone will be at 1843 MHz at the output of the DSC. So set the interpolation equals to 8. In the signal plot panel, set the frequency domain and select DSA output. Set the frequency domain and select the DSA output. This is useful for frequency planning by displaying the interpolated signal at the DSA output sampling date post mixer. Finally, press configure and then download to transfer the signal data from MATLAB to DSC memory buffer of the board. At this point, the RFDSC is continuously transmitting a 1 MHz tone digitally mixed with 1842 MHz carrier to emerge 1843 MHz from RFSoC board through the TX signal chain of the Qorvo card, front end card. The output of the power amplifier is coupled with through the DPD observation path towards the RF arrays of the signal capture. So return to the main tab and descend into ADC tile 3, select signal capture and press acquire. Type A at the terminal command followed by carriage return, then enter the value 119 to decrease the attenuation by 1.6 dB. The signal level should now be approximately ZDBS full scale. This is the 1 MHz signal. That's all.